wings and have a key to its low final approach speed, allowing the aircraft to land and stop on short, unimproved airfields. Ladies and gentlemen, please get your cameras ready, as this will be your best opportunity to take photos of this state-of-the-art machine. C-17's capabilities, an assault landing to a combat backing. Note, the engine's open for reverse thrust. C-17 is currently about to...
Hand-eye coordination to maintain the mission position roughly 3 meters apart.
3 meters apart?
Today we are watching Trent Sherman and Rule at 6 Flight Lieutenant Ben Hepworth. C-130 Hercules prior to his time as an instructor on the PC-9 and now PC-21. He has over 3,500 hours of military flying, and this is his 8th season with the team. Three-meter separation between two aircraft. Today's heart in the sky is dedicated. display the solo performance characteristics of the PC-21 through a vertical roll and maximum performance turn.
Is this aircraft more efficient for that training than the PC-9?
Absolutely. The systems involved in the PC-21 now sets up a pilot to step onto the hawk and then into the joint strike fighter.
Excellent, excellent. Well, the nuts and bolts and the bits and pieces that bring the Air Force together, let's have a listen to this before we get into the one-hour display of your RAAF.
Thank you. yet another capability that makes the Rhino such an intimidating.
Maneuvers that you never thought possible.
At high speed, pitch out into the circuit and configure for landing. Squat the jet and light the burners one last time.